First of the three heroes was Amadeus, a wizard. Not perhaps the bravest or the most powerful, but he was clever and sensible. Then there was Pontius the knight, fearless protector of the realm, who loved good food, drink, and battle. Last but not least, Amadeus the wizard was asleep in his cottage. It was a place where he could study his fireball spell, hidden from the
How very strange.
The path ahead was blocked, but this wouldn't stop the great wizard, Amadeus. With his magic, he could lift objects. Amadeus could also conjure boxes out of thin air. The light moved through the forest, leading Amadeus further. Torn between fear and wonder, he followed.
I demand to know what's happening. The trine. Pontius!
Pontius had headed out that evening, for there was trouble on the peasant farms. Creeping vines were taking over the fields.
A warlock must be behind this devilry. I'll find him and teach him a lesson with my sword. With luck. There'll be pumpkin pie for dinner tonight.
Pontius searched the farm, but saw no one there.
The nasties must have fled at the sight of me. Whoa!
Oh, that looks dangerous. Blasted weeds. I'll show you what for. I'm Pontius the Brave, and I won't fall in a battle with dandelions. The train!
Pontius had never understood. Late that night, Zoya was concealed in the shadows, hidden from the shimmering moonlight. Zoya passed through the town as quietly as a whisper. Then she saw a glimmering light moving on top of the old church.
The train. How inconvenient.